I thought it was in there. Maybe I left it in the car too.
Yeah, shit.
Oh, that guy has the ball right now.
Yeah.
Now we're trying to leave it to Drew to kick. Motivation in practice. He is not fun in practice.
Yeah.
He tries during the game, but practice is something else.
Goalkeeper!
What?
Yeah.
Yo, you got me.
Hey, how you place?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Quick, quick.
Yo, you got me.
Eight now.
Oh, man, that was.
I didn't call you about the tournament. I actually figured out it all. I figured it all by myself.
Good. Yeah, I saw your husband. I was like, I recognize these people. Who are these people? Is Head Knit where's?
He's not out there.
Oh, I was going to say.
I didn't see him. He got a record. He's going to a hearing on the 21st.
Well, that's not good.
No, it was really, really, really bad. We had, well, I'm not going to get into it. They're accusing him of referee assault.
Wow.
Yeah, it's really bad.
Did he actually do anything?
No,
in your opinion?
He was the captain.
Uh-huh.
So he was asking for an explanation.
Uh-huh.
So when he ran up, the guy was giving another player a red card. And so he was trying, he said, I'm the captain, I want an explanation, I want to talk to you, I want an explanation, I'm the captain. So he came out of the goal to have field. And then he wasn't getting the guy's attention, the guy was just, and then he turned for him to get back to his goal. And Hayden just said, I'm the captain. And so he like touched him, so he assaulted him.
That seems unreasonable.
So we had a attorney, we had to.
So it's not just a soccer offense, it's some criminal offense?
It is a soccer offense. It is just a soccer offense, but they said the minimum is 3 months, which will put him out the whole season, which messes up his...
everything.
Yeah. Coaches can't come see, can't, you know. And so we feel like that that's just, you know, and anybody who knows Hayden knows that if he was going to go to the ref, it wasn't going to be an assault, you know. He's trying to prove. He wasn't even from Georgia. He's from North Carolina. At the public school. He's at the public school. So it's just been really bad. So he can't go to practice. He can't go to the TV. And in the Georgia soccer region as a spectator, or on the field, he can't be even at practice or anything until the hearing.
But this is his team that play all here?
Yeah, on the team.
Oh, great. Fun stuff, huh?
It's like, you know what? It's not about the kids anymore. That's what makes me so mad. It's just never about the kids anymore. It's all about whatever. Whatever it has to be, but it's never about...
Everything's complicated nowadays. Nothing's just simple.
It is.
In anything.
I know.
Yeah, you just want to play soccer and...
It's sad. It's just really sad. We've come to all of that. But what about y'all's family? Is he okay? How did he get an accident?
That's all I've heard.
Okay.
I've heard he's okay, but he's obviously not playing today. That's our U16 keeper.
I mean, we don't know when we get him back if we're going to get him back.
Yeah.
Get a rust in the back.
For these guys?
Yeah.
No.
Thank you. I had to go print one at the FedEx store because I didn't have the official. I didn't know I had to have one. So I just rode to FedEx to get it.
Okay, thank you. That's what I did.
See who's who?
Yeah.
You know, on which team?
I know Grant, Sam, Ravi.
I saw on your team. I thought you were looking at this one.
Oh no, I was.
You were taking off. Gotcha. I figured I'd go at half halftime and just tell him, sorry, I didn't have these. I had to go run to the store. And we handed him a handwritten one for now.
Yeah, I shouldn't have accepted that.
I know.
It was nice of them to do it. I wouldn't have.
They told me they weren't starting until 6:15, but the coach wouldn't get here, so I was back actually. But they had already started.
Yeah, if they don't hurry up, they're gonna run out of light. There's no lights in this field.
Mm-hmm.
We were out of practice on Thursday, right? And about 8:15, you couldn't see a thing.
Yeah. How's Sam doing?
Good.
Yeah. School going good? Is he a senior this year?
Yeah.
Does he want to play in college?
He wants to.
Yeah.
He got any offers.
No, we don't either, so. We have some that are saying that they want to come see, but we haven't.
We've sent him to 6 or 7 ID camps, and
I think that's the way to do it.
He's done some visits, and he's got, thinks he knows where he wants to play, but he hasn't got any offers.
Yeah.
And I don't think he will.
I think he's just not, I think he's, now that all of this has taken place, it's just kind of like, Mom, I just think I want to go to college. I said, well, that's an option. Certainly it's an option.
There's nothing wrong with that.
I said, it's sad that it made you feel that way, but this year don't.
Well, you can still play intramural and
that's what I said.
Be a referee.
You know, if you calm down, you can walk on somewhere, try to, you know, whatever. Just I think he wants to go to East Tennessee State, so we'll see.
Do you know what he wants to study?
Either physical therapy or nurse practitioner, maybe, or some PA, maybe. I'm not sure exactly which route. Also considering military after 4 years.
That was not a foul. Should you call that a foul, Will?
I mean, yeah, I would have.
Was he extended?
Yeah. Okay. I mean, I think he would have exaggerated. He could have stayed up, but sure, yeah.
That's what I was seeing.
Who doesn't? It's soccer.
I would have called it.
Well, good to see you, and thank you. If I have your email now, so if I do need help.
Yeah, anything, anytime.
I called the director, because I've never done this, and I was like, I had to have game cards for the tournaments, but I haven't been able to find anything for game cards for games. And she's like, oh yeah, you have to go, it says tournaments or something. I'm like, oh, nice.
Yeah, they call everything's a tournament. The season is a tournament in their language.
And so I said, well, I'm going to have to, I just looked in the phone, I was like, okay, where's FedEx?
Well, now, I mean, once you find it the first time, you'll be fine.
Right. Yeah, I went ahead and printed today's and tomorrow's, so I just have
it. And you can't print them until, like,
a day before Wednesday or something?
Thursday.
Really? Yeah. I figured that when I saw that I could do both, I thought, okay, I'm here, I'm just doing it. Yeah. I'm already paying.
Yeah. But, like, you couldn't go in and print out next week.
Right.
Yet.
Right.
I don't know when they turn them loose, but
I saw Elizabeth at Hayden went to watch some of the boys play in Athens at the Athens tournament. So we saw Elizabeth and some of those kids over there. That was fun. Seth and I can't remember some of them.
I think Dylan's up there.
Dylan, yep. We saw Dylan. So that was fun.
Daryl and I have been texting a little bit back and forth.
I told him they all should get together sometime. Hayden would love that.
I was thinking about trying to find a group email from last year and just saying, I hope everyone's having a great season and good luck to everyone.
We enjoyed
it. It was a good group.
It was a great group. It's just, we had great parents and everything. It was just great. We didn't have that good luck last year. And playing, it was a great honor for him to make that team, but it wasn't. It wasn't the exposure that you think.
Really?
I don't think so. I think you get just as good by taking yourself to all the camps. You know, when you're interested in a school, you just have to be in front of them and email them all the time. And I think you get as much exposure without having to pay the premium season fees. I think it helped him and everything, but you know, it was just one of those things. I wouldn't do it again.
Interesting. Yeah, it's just soccer in the end. And none of these kids are going to go pro, and hardly any of them will get into college. So enjoy, it should be fun.
Yeah, and
it wasn't fun.
It wasn't. It was the travel was exhausting. It was exhausting. I mean, we didn't play weekends, but Russia. And we play with people from somewhere in Harbor. The minimum 4 hours away, you know? It was always a weekend away with the hotels, and it just wasn't one. It wasn't worth the exposure. I don't think the exposure was as good as what. And Hades aren't interested in who plays with Clemson.
Yeah.
He knows he's going to play for a small.
Yeah.
So it wasn't worth to me the travel expenses and the dealings. It's more fun to be with.
And the intensity is a little bit less.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's more fun. It's more family. Friendly even.
Do I smell like all the stuff on these two legs, except my shorts? Although these are a little long.
You really got a bad deal.
Have you seen the new ones, like snakeskin ones?
So are there special like sports attorneys that you hire for that type of stuff?
Well, we have a really good friend that played high school for 4 years with him, whose dad is an attorney, and so we just went to him. His son played OVP, and so he knows the rules and the regulations real good of soccer, so we just went to him for advice for right now. Mm-hmm. And he said that UFA is such a big club that they should have their own attorney, and if they don't, he would be glad to just come with us. But that he's never done it before. But we felt like because he knows Hayden's character and he knows Hayden, and he's been around him for so long.
It says that
he can pull up the fact that he's never had yellow, so he's certainly not a pilot.
And have a history.
Right.
It says they're available
and
now, but I think they're
his character as well. So we were feeling like it would be better for him to try to go. And then we're just trying to get people from the team. Some of the parents said they would undoubtedly go and testify for him that it was just insane. I think it'll be okay, but whether or not they change anything, you know, who knows?
Yeah, it's not just a cliche.
So is it? They've decided and you're trying to counteract it, or is it there's a hearing to decide what?
It's called a discipline and protest hearing.
No, you can
so they, that was, like, they will hand down the discipline and we get to protest the, basically.
They kind of already have decided.
Yeah. Yeah, he's guilty until proven innocent, basically. It's kind of backwards the way that, you know. And the minimum is 3 months to 5 years is the sentence. You can throw down for that. Like, he was trying to get his attention and be back in control of the game. Like, he was trying to say, look, I'm the captain, I need you to talk to me. So like, he's going off the field.
There's some people that are going to be waiting for them.
Oh, there you go, Rob.
Sad. It was sad. It really was.
Well, technically, according to the rules, the captain has no... he doesn't have a right to do... people think it's the captain's job to go. But if you read the rules... It says specifically that being the captain gives you no
extra
rights or authority on the field other than something about the discipline of your own team. So the referee didn't have to
acknowledge
speak to him just because he's the captain. If he doesn't want to, no, he probably should have.
Yeah, he was being... Really what happened was the parents on the sideline were out of control too. Because of a call that had gotten called back, the side ref had called one way and the center changed his mind, which made a goal call on us. And so the parents were mad, it escalated. And he didn't have any explanations of what had happened, and the easiest thing for him to do was throw that card that was already in his hand. That's the way we feel about it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it wasn't like... Wasn't like that kid at Chattahoochee who attacked the ref that day. You know what I mean?
He didn't come at him with a fist.
Yeah, exactly. But
and in the pro game, I hate the fact that they're always, you know, the referee make a call. All the players come out and bump him and push him and shove him. And I think it shouldn't be allowed in the pro game.
Mm-mm.
It should be the same as in football. You touch the referee, you're out. But that's certainly not how it is. And if they're going to do that in youth soccer, suddenly...
The whole thing with the coaches having to have so many qualifications and so many... But the refs are still not having to have that. You know, they've got to do something. But they've got... I mean, I know that they're having trouble getting them, but they've got to be held accountable to something, too. Like, they've got to be able to... You can't just take this guy from North Carolina and have him come for the Georgia Public's Cup and say... He's got the final word on. Like, I think Hayden has. I think Hayden should be able to explain himself rather than just say, "Okay, you're done. You're done."
Yeah.
The whole
well, that's the point. That's the purpose of the meeting, right?
Yeah, I hope that that's the purpose of the meeting. I don't know whether it's already been decided or we don't know. We've never known.
Yeah, I've never. I mean, I would imagine Georgia soccer's going to want to side with the referee, but if you make a good enough argument, you know, maybe they'll do. Okay, you're still guilty, but it's a one-game suspension
right,
or something like that.
Right, or whatever, yeah. Because by the time we have the hearing, he'll already be out four games.
So maybe you can do time served.
And if you're just going to start making an example now, you can't, I know for a fact in multiple games, somebody has approached the ref and touched the ref or talked to the ref, and there's been refs that have said, like, okay, look, calm down. I'm going to talk to you. Just, but he was just like, I'm done with all of you. Red cards everywhere. But it'll be okay. You know what? Maybe it's meant to be. Maybe it's meant to be over, and it's okay. You know, maybe... Maybe Hayden has other plans for him. And it doesn't include soccer. That's why I told Hayden, you just have to be prepared that even though it would break your heart, there might be better, something better that's not soccer. That's different waiting, you know? But that's easier said than when you're 17 and your heart's been. I guess I do take this to the center, right? Wouldn't he be the one that...
I didn't get a water break. Can I put it
at
2 o'clock?
Okay.
Yeah, you could give it... Yeah. So you could give it to the Arab, but I wouldn't give it to this one. If you're on that side, you could give it to Kimber, but... Yeah, just give it to him at halftime.
Dude, when I played in my game, I started the first half when I came off...
At Def Center, what do you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Well, it doesn't really matter.
Oh, okay.
Because they're going to come together at halftime anyway.
So I could get just run down.
Yeah, you can give it to her now.
I didn't get a water break when I played.
I know.
Like 96
and it was
though.
Hotter.
What?
And it was hotter then.
Yeah. You got shade.
Yes, same. What happened to your first cut? I don't know. It's not very trusting.
I
don't
know if somebody can get it.
Yeah,
I got it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah!
No.
I mean, the first thing I do is donate money to the real me That's pretty good. All right, let's get back. You'll make up all that money back. I won't.
Oh, like one of those.
I wouldn't even need a quarter.
You're seeing those things where it's like how much people make in a second.
Yeah.
Dang, bro. How is this fucking goal kicks in our game? What?
Who's the inventor to
you? Oh, the defender. Dang! You better start taking goal kicks.
Oh,
He's just taking it off.
There's nobody there.
I go on the end of the bat, you want to walk all the way over there. In case you can't go on it.
Thank you. One, two, three.
Hey,
So.
Left.
Good ball.
Oh.